In this video, we'll see how to create a new workbook with the help of Excel macros. So now, usually if you want to create a workbook, that is Excel workbook, there are many methods. When the Excel workbook, Excel file is not open, and if you want to create a workbook, we can just right click on the screen and you can see as Excel worksheet, that's Excel workbook here, that is one created. Or else the second method is you can just open an Excel file. In that Excel file, you can create new workbooks. You can keep on creating. So I'll show that. I'll go to this place, that is E drive. Okay, this E drive, if I double click on this place, in the previous video, if you remember, that is VBA cell referencing. That was one area, one section which I've done. After that, there was sheet referencing. Now here onwards, anything if I do with the workbook worksheets, that will be in this workbook referencing workbook itself. If I just double click and open, all the coding part related to workbook will be written here onwards, right? Now here it is, the Excel workbook. The name is Excel VBA workbook referencing. Now if you want to create a new workbook, you can press Ctrl N from a keyboard. Okay, Ctrl N like this. Okay, and a new workbook will be created. Okay, if you want, you can close it. Otherwise, usually what you do is you go to this file, click on this new and select this blank workbook. So if you click on this blank workbook, still you can create a workbook. But if I want to automate this process, if I want to create a macro for this, how do I do that? Please see this. I'll go to this developer tab. I've already written a code at the back end. Developer tab, and I can go to this Visual Basic. Okay, now in this place, if you see, I've created a module named as workbook create. Inside that, I've written a macro. There are two methods to create a workbook. One is without the name and second is with a name. So if you see, I've created sub procedure workbook create, and I've said as I want to workbooks.add. I want to add a workbook here, workbooks.add without name. There's no name given here. If you want to add a name, what you can do is workbooks.add dot save as, same copy paste here, dot save as, the file name is given, colon equal to, and the path of the file. Okay, so that is E drive. I have written the name of the file as demobook.xlsx. So that's a new name of the file. Now if I execute step by step, please observe what will happen. I'll keep my cursor here and I'll go to this debug toolbar, and if I click on this step into, now it is given as workbooks.add. If you observe here, right now I have Excel VBA workbook referencing. I'll click on step into, something blinked. That was actually, it was creating a workbook, that is book to Excel. Okay, therefore there was a no name which is given here. Now if I show you here at the bottom, if you see here, and if I scroll down here, if you see, yeah. Now if you see, there are two Excel workbooks, that is book 2 and that is Excel VBA, and that is nothing but a VBA window itself. Okay, let's see. If I execute the second line, if I click on this step into, see the name of the file will be changed. If I click on this step into, again it blinked. Actually it was creating a file. The name of the file is demobook.xlsx, that is demo book, which is saved. Now let me show you whether the file is actually created. It created, and it opened the file, so you can see that file. Let me show you how many files I have at the bottom. Yeah, now I have total, that is demo book, book 2, and that is one Excel VBA, and that is VBA editor. Now let me show you the address where the location was there. It was in the E drive. I'll show the E drive whether the file was actually created or not. So I'll just open this folder. Yeah, that's a folder. If you see, there's a demo book which is given here, and the extension is .xlsx. If I just press Alt Enter, Alt Enter is the shortcut key, and if you see, that is .xls extension, and the location is in the E drive, so it's working fine. Okay, and I'll just close this dialog box. Okay, now I'll come to this place. I'll again press step into so that it comes out of the macro part, right? And I'll just click on close part, right? So I hope you're able to understand how to create an Excel workbook with name and without name in the macros part. That's all for this video.